Hey guys, what's up? Welcome back to the channel. How are you guys doing today? To the people newly subscribing or new to the channel, newly subscribing, please hit the like button, hit subscribe. To the people who've been here before, thank you very much for all the love and support. Hope you guys are doing well. Well, today's video mainly is being shot because of the comments I've been reading from especially Alric. So Alric says that we should do a lot of food, we should do some, you know, food vlogs. So today I'm in Panjim, in the heart of Panjim, at this restaurant. It's a typical Goan, authentic Goan food. The name of the restaurant is called Gudino Bar and Restaurant. Now it is owned, I know I keep saying he's a friend of mine, but what to do? I mean, Goa is so small, everybody knows each other. But when I talk about a friend of mine, this guy's name is Keza Gudino. He's a childhood friend of mine. We were from Shada Mandir from like third standard till Don Bosco's, even our college. We did basketball. We played basketball together. We used to represent Goa for basketball. But yeah, his food is mainly, it started in 1938. It was from his dad's. He'll be explaining it all to you. I shall show you the place. It's right here. It's called Gudino Bar and Restaurant. And the Panjim, the main Panjim church is that side. It's around that side out there. From the Panjim church, this is hardly about a 5-minute walk. You've got Cafe Beausoleil, which is out there. Cafe Beausoleil is right out there. And this is called Gudino Bar and Restaurant. If you see, authentic Goan food since 1938. Let's have a go inside. So this is the place. You've got an AC section out here, and here's the bar. You've got the bar out here. And as you see around, it's got a lot of Portuguese influence to it, like Lisboa. You've got a lot of Portugal fan, the flags. This was his grandfather and grandmother, and my favorite, personal favorite, is the dog. And here we have Keza himself. So he's Mr. Keza, the famous classmate of mine. So Keza, we are here at your restaurant today. What do you got for us?
Well, we got a lot of dishes that line up here.
Okay.
So we have the thali,
okay.
The famous thali over here.
Fish thali?
Fish thali.
Okay.
And we have the veg thali also.
Okay.
We have our famous pork vindaloo.
Ooh, pork vindaloo, nice.
Yeah.
That's a traditional Goan dish, isn't it?
And our best selling chicken kafriyal.
Chicken kafriyal. Fair enough. Cool then. So guys, I'll catch you in the next one as soon as the food arrives. Ciao. He's giving us something known as a hambucha. It is a Chinese drink actually that is extracted out of tea, black tea. It's supposed to be pretty healthy. It's pretty healthy, and I shall show you. These are the bottles. This is an apple and cinnamon hambucha, 100% homemade. You've got the pomegranate. And the best one of it all, I think, is the green tea that you have. And so they do sell this here at their restaurant. If you see here, available here, 100% homemade kombucha. So anytime you guys are in Panjim side, don't forget to drop by Gudino Bar and Restaurant. Ask for Keza, or you'll meet his brother Kenneth out there. If not, the dad is always there. And yes, I do recommend this. I'll catch you. I'm going to enjoy the food now. Ciao. So we end, he's allowed me to get back in the kitchen, to come here in the kitchen. And I'll show you how they make the pork vindaloo. There we go. This is the traditional Goan pork vindaloo. Now he's gonna add the masala, the vindaloo masala. That gives it the nice red flavor to it. And as you can see, we've got all the good masalas, all the tasty local masalas, and onions and tomatoes and the chilies all lined up here. Along with the kombucha, I'm going to be having beer, which is always a favorite. You know, in Goa, we have a saying, we don't drink water, we drink beer, it's cheaper. And I think the saying's kind of true, because you know, if you throw a stone in Goa, it's going to hit either a church, a temple, or a bar. There are about 4,000 legal bars in Goa, you can imagine the illegal amount. But anyway, I'm going to show you some of the local beers that are here. The Goa Rice Lager you've got. Obviously, Peoples, that's the favorite. Budweiser, my ultimate favorite, Kingfisher, and you've got Carlsberg. These are the main selling alcohols in Goa. And yeah, a chilled beer always goes good with a nice fish thali. That's the best thing ever. Anyway, I'll catch you in the next. Guys, the food has arrived. I shall show you what all we have here. So this is the fish thali. You've got the local fish curry. We've got we call it in Konkani, tamari bhaji. That is a red leafy vegetable. This is crabs. As you can see, you've got the crabs. These are your dry prawns. And then the sol curry, which is when you finish eating, you normally have that. It's good for digestion. Your papad, the rice, and this is the pork, vindaloo. You've got your chicken kafriel, which they are famous at this restaurant for. And here's your veg thali with the curd, the sol curry, the tamari bhaji. You've got a cauliflower vegetable and your dal with it. You've got. So we are gonna get eating and we'll catch you later. Ciao. Okay, so we're gonna get started with the food. We've got obviously the staple Kingfisher beer. I'm going to be trying the veg thali, okay, and he's having the fish, and obviously there's the pork. This is going to be a little bit spicy, I know for a fact. And one thing with me, whenever it's spicy, you're going to see me sweat a lot, so excuse me for that. And we've got the kafriel as well, the chicken kafriel as well out here. So I'm going to dig in. Now normally we eat with our hands, but I'm going to use a fork and a spoon. Yeah. So normally with this, you get in the veg thali, you have a chapati as well. And the papad, nice and hot, should be had, crispy. The rice. Okay, you know what? I'm just going to eat with my hands. Put some dal on top of it.
Would you like some curry?
I'll have later. I'll try a little of that. Let's try the veg first. You gotta mix it really well. So the trick is normally the thumb is used as a spoon to push it and you make a morsel. This is what a tadka?
Yeah.
Veg tadka. And the pickle. What pickle is it?
Mango.
Mango pickle. Pretty good. Pretty decent. So normally if you see my channel, it's going to be mostly non-veg. But for some of the veg people, is why I'm doing this. I'm doing this for y'all, okay? So yeah, I'd seen in the comments, some people were asking, now in Goa, because of the rains, do we get a lot of fish thali and stuff like that?
We do get.
Fish thali, yeah, we will get fish thali, but I think the prices will go higher.
Yes, because the most prices go higher on Kingfish. and on snapper fish.
Okay.
But nowadays we have our, what is that called?
The fisheries.
Yeah,
the fisheries, the where they raise
where they
the fish.
Where they breed the fish there.
They breed the fish, okay, fair enough. Like in next to my house, there's this place that has opened. It's called Catch and Carry. We'll be doing a video there as well. So I've seen, they've got these aquariums, like these big aquariums, like, you know, huge ones, and they've got the live fish there. So whichever you want, you take the net and you remove the live one from there, basically.
That's nice, man.
But only thing, that will be a little bit expensive, but obviously, I mean, you're getting fresh. How much more fresh can you get from that, basically? Catch and Carry, it's next to Red Rosary, right?
Yeah,
I've
seen the boat. I didn't know what it was.
Because
the fish tank.
No, because one of my friends yesterday from South, where I did the shoot, if you've seen the video of the burgers, Dylan. So he's from South. In his Instagram story, I seen that.
Okay.
And you know, you actually catch the fish live and you can take it home. Pretty neat. Only thing, I don't know how you're going to kill it after that. I wouldn't want to go through that. Good. I'm not going to have much of the veg. Like, I'm scared to have the cauliflower. I mean, my favorite vegetable would be bhindi, lady fingers, okra. That's my ultimate favorite. So now it's time to try the vindaloo. The pork vindaloo. You see the size of that pork, the chunk, the pieces they give you? That's one thing, you know, after school, when we were in 8th standard, 8th to 10th standard, Kaiser, me, the other group of friends, Kaiser, we guys used to come here and have our lunch here. And every day, like about four or five of us close friends, we used to have lunch here. And this one guy, Kaiser, so he used to like eat fast, you know, eat like really fast, finish everything. And we are left like, you know, with nothing in our plate because he's eating from our plate. So, I mean, this place brings back memories. It's more like home for us. And the food is also authentic. So the best part with the pork is not that spicy. Like if you see South Goa, their food is always really, really spicy, you know, in South Goa. Here, too, like whenever I eat in South Goa, I just sweat. This is pretty good, pretty decent, the right amount of spice, I feel. And then the kafriel, I don't even have to taste it. I know how good it is with the smell itself. You know how good it is with the smell itself. But yeah, nice big fat pieces.
Good fried crab.
Yeah.
That's pretty neat.
You see, they actually give you big pieces of crab. And you just gotta suck into this. Ah, pretty good, man. When you talk about authentic Goan food, what do we eat? Majority. Seafood, a little bit, if you're like mostly Catholics would have pork and beef. But then another famous thing in Goa is cutlet pav, the beef cutlet. We've not had that in a while, cutlet pav. Then you have a lot of kafriel. Chicken kafriel is main. That is made out of coriander, grounded coriander paste with a lot of chilies and, you know, Indian spices that are added to it. That's a traditional Goan thing. But me, if you ask me, this pork, the swine, is fine, divine, sublime and right on time. So we are going to eat now. I'll catch you after that. Ciao. So we are back. Struggled. As you can see, the plates, the thalis are all empty out here.
Mine's empty. I don't know about you.
Mine's, yeah, sort of. I mean, I tried. Veg, I mean, I tried. But yes, the fish thali was really, really amazing, especially with the crabs at the side of it. The accompaniment. Yes, the dal also was good at tadka. I really did like that. And now I think it's going... He's gonna have the lassi with it. But while he has his lassi, I'm gonna have my beer. I'll catch you guys in the next. Ciao. So that's it for this vlog. Hope you guys enjoyed it. Whenever in Goa, if you're in North Goa, in Panjim, Panjim area, especially people come to visit the casinos, which are like a 5-minute walking distance from here. Or if you go to the Panjim Church, which is also, people call it the Josh Church. Which one was that? With Aishwarya Rai? Yeah, Josh. Where the movie Josh was shot, they sit on the steps of that church. So that church is about 5 minutes from this restaurant. We are right in the heart of the city. And do not forget to drop by at Gudino Bar and Restaurant. Whenever you're here, please ask for Kaiser, ask for his brother Kenneth. They're always ready to help you. And yeah, Kaiser, thank you very much for today.
Most welcome.
Yeah, hopefully, all the best with the business and let it move more further. And you guys, I'll catch you all in the next vlog. Do like and subscribe. Ciao.